Save Our Monarchs Foundation would like to thank our partners at Omaha Public Power District for their bold efforts to restore monarch butterfly habitat. The Save Our Monarchs Foundation works with gardeners, schools, public agencies, and utility companies to restore pollinator habitat and provide monarch butterfly education. The goal of this video is to explain why these animals are so important to us and what you can do to help. The life cycle of the monarch butterfly is a natural process that you can witness from your own home. After all, nature is the best teacher. Like all butterflies, the monarch's life cycle consists of a series of changes called metamorphosis. The four stages of the monarch butterfly life cycle are egg, caterpillar, chrysalis, and finally adult butterfly. Life begins as a tiny egg that the female monarch lays on the underside of a milkweed leaf. The caterpillar then hatches in 3 to 12 days. Just 2 millimeters long, it is small enough to fit inside the head of a pin, but it will not stay that size for long. Young caterpillars have one job, and that's to eat so they can grow quickly. They shed their skin several times, each time marking the start of a new life stage called an instar. The caterpillars will eat nonstop for about 2 weeks before they enter the chrysalis stage. About a week or two later, they finish their metamorphosis and emerge as fully formed black and orange adult monarch butterflies. The adult monarch butterfly spends its time feeding on nectar from flowers and reproducing, beginning the life cycle once again. Butterflies are not only beautiful, but their biology has also inspired useful advancements in technology. The study of their wings is being used to make better solar panels, wind turbine blades, and propellers. Scientists are also studying the adhesive secretions that moths produce to stick their eggs to their host plants. They hope to mimic this natural product to create everyday adhesives. The Eastern Monarch migration covers a great deal of space on the North American continent, connecting plants, people, and pollinators along the way. Each fall, they travel from their summer breeding grounds to overwintering locations in central Mexico. Eastern monarchs can travel an astonishing 3,000 miles in 1 year. The western monarch population overwinters in eucalyptus trees along the California coast. Tagging studies have shown that some western monarchs even migrate to central Mexico to mix with the eastern monarch population. The monarch is an indicator species that we can use to gauge the health of other populations of pollinator species. Researchers and citizen scientists count the monarchs every year to find out how to better manage lands in order to maintain healthy populations. The most vital component of monarch habitat is milkweed, and despite its name, it is not a weed, but a plant native to North America. In fact, there are about 100 species of milkweed found in North America, and 17 species found only in Nebraska. Milkweed is the sole host plant of monarchs, meaning that monarch caterpillars will only eat this plant. Milkweed is a long-lived perennial with a long taproot that stores carbon and helps control erosion. Due to loss of habitat in the monarch's primary breeding grounds, milkweed has become much more scarce. In 2014, the United States, Canada, and Mexico came together to help bring back the monarchs by creating the Monarch Conservation Implementation Plan. This plan called for the planting of 1.5 billion milkweed plants. In addition to milkweed, adult monarch butterflies need nectar-rich flowers as food sources. As we'll discuss later, flowering plants play an important role in supporting monarchs. The need to feed a growing population often conflicts with the need to preserve and create protected biodiverse habitat. This map displays the pressure of that conflict. As you can see here, the primary breeding grounds of the monarch overlap with areas of intense crop production. So how can we coexist with these insects that help to pollinate our food crops while maintaining space to grow this food? This is a complex issue that requires a lot of teamwork and collaboration from utility companies, farmers, ranchers, and gardeners. The good news is we are making progress and you can do your part. We humans have an amazing capacity to adapt, and because of this ability, we have been very successful as a species. However, this success does not come without costs, and we now find ourselves with the important task of protecting and restoring natural environments that have been compromised. Monarch butterfly populations, along with the populations of many insect and bird species, are in steep decline. There is new evidence emerging all the time that compels us to act in order to sustain the amazing biodiversity of our planet. This requires us to shift the way we interact with our landscapes in order to coexist with the species that contribute to our food supply. 75% of the world's flowering plants depend on animal pollinators to reproduce. That means that one out of every three bites of food you eat is there because of pollinators. This map shows the conservation targets for the monarch butterflies from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. You can see here that eastern Nebraska is in the red zone of primary breeding habitat, so it is a priority area for conservation efforts. The big question that we have to ask ourselves is, where are we going to put 1.5 billion new stems of milkweed that will help stabilize the monarch population? The answer is, anywhere we can. Can you think of a place where you can install pollinator plants? To quote Doug Ptolemy, the author of Bringing Nature Home, it is time to garden like our lives depend on it. There is a place we can look to plant pollinator habitat, and it is closer than you might think. Did you know that lawns are the largest irrigated crop in the U.S.? Each year, we drench our lawns with enough water to fill the Chesapeake Bay. Lawns are a popular choice because of their lack of bug interactions and soft texture. However, lawns do not support a single pollinator species. You can help change that by creating a healthy ecosystem of plants in your yard. You can host native bees, butterflies, hummingbirds, and other pollinators in your yard by providing them with the host and nectar plants they need to survive. You can also provide them with a safe space to shelter and water to drink. Save the turf grasses for the areas where you like to walk barefoot and leave the rest for the pollinators. Making a pollinator garden with lots of Nebraska wildflowers is a great way you can help these small critters. While many pollinator species are struggling with declining populations, it can be important to distinguish them. For instance, honeybees are different from wild bees. Honeybees were brought to this continent from Europe and Asia. In North America, there are over 4,000 species of native bees, most of which are solitary and don't live in hives. These bees lay eggs in bare ground and hollow branches and stems. This kind of abundance of species are a great example of biodiversity. By having many species of bees, ecosystems are more resilient to changes, whether that be from weather, predators, or other disturbances. So you might be asking yourself, what can I do to help? And our response is, if you plant it, they will come. If you can dedicate a portion of your yard to plants that support pollinators, they will find them. So please consider making part of your lawn a native plant habitat. Biodiversity applies to all plant life. Like other species, plants are either endemic or cosmopolitan. Endemic means they are historically from the area that they are found and evolved to survive and reproduce in the conditions found there. Cosmopolitan species are those that are imported from other areas and have not evolved in the community in which they are found. Think of the monarch and its host plant, the milkweed. Monarchs and milkweed co-evolved to support each other and have a symbiotic relationship beneficial to both of them. Without milkweeds, monarchs would have no host plants and could not reproduce. So if there were no milkweeds, there would be no monarchs. In North America, oak trees are the endemic biodiversity champions. Oaks host over 450 unique species, meaning that if there were no oak trees, there would be 450 fewer insect species out there. Imported plants like Japanese maple and ginkgos do not host any insect species in North America. You can help by planting native species of plants that support local pollinator communities.